In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you. And with your spirit.
Good afternoon.
And to you, Father.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind us. I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting
life. Amen.
Lord, help us.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, help us.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us learn what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians. Christ is proclaimed, and that makes me happy, and I shall continue being happy, beginning because I know that this will help save me, thanks to your prayers, and to the help which was given to me by the Spirit of Jesus. My one hope and trust is that I shall never have to admit defeat, but that now as always I shall have the courage for Christ to be glorified in my body, whether by my life or by my death. Life to me, of course, is Christ, but then death will bring me something more. But then again, if living in this body means doing work which is having good results, I don't know what I should choose. I am caught in this dilemma. I want to be gone and be with Christ, which will be very much the better. For for me to stay alive in this body is a more urgent need for your sake. This weighs with me so much that I feel sure I shall survive and stay in it all, and help me to progress in the faith and even increase your joyment. And so you will have another reason to give praise to Christ Jesus on my account when I am with you again. This is the word of the Lord.
And
in response to the psalm, my soul is thirsting to God, the God of my life.
My soul is thirsting to God, the God of my life.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God.
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. When can I enter and see the face of God?
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
I will lead the rejoicing crowd into the house of God, amid cries of praise and thanksgiving.
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
And the gospel of commission. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Then the message of Christ in all its richness by the Holy. Through him, give thanks to God the Father. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according
to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord.
Now on a Sabbath day, Jesus had gone for a meal to the house of one of the leading Pharisees, and they watched him closely. He then told them to the parable, because he had noticed how they picked the place of honour. He said this: when someone invites you to a wedding feast, do not take your seat in the place of honour. The more distinguished person than you may have been invited, and the person who invited you both may come and say, give up your place to this man, and then to your embarrassment, you have to go and take the lowest place. Know when you are a guest, make your way to the lower place and sit there, so that when your host comes, he may say, "My friend, do not hide." In that way, everyone with you at the table will see you honored. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and the man who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I was for some years chaplain to St. Bede's Catholic School in Bristol, and each year they used to have a prize giving. They used to invite a celebrity to this prize giving. It was various people, some people well known, some people not so well known. And I always was invited to come and be part of what was called the top table on the stage. And I always used to sit in the same seat, never really questioned it. And there was a small procession in, and we would take our places, and we would sit down. This one particular year, however, I was told by the head teacher that I took my usual place. "No fun, Tom, you're not on the stage today. You've got to go and sit down because we've got two guest speakers." I didn't know this. And I had to stand up in the midst of everyone and walk down the steps and find my place in the lower part of the hall. I was very embarrassed. This hadn't happened before. And I was maybe thinking, well, maybe I should have found out a bit more about which place I should have sat before I went in. The head teacher did come up to me afterwards and apologised for the rudeness of her action. She and I got very well, and I forgave her. Jesus is reminding those Pharisees in today's Gospel that they really should take the lower place first and not fight for the places of honour. And I suppose there is always a point that we can take from this, in the sense that we're always called to humble ourselves in the midst of times and where we know that we will be lifted up. We pray for the church, for all of God's holy people, that we may always be seen as servants to all. Lord, in your mercy, pray for our world and its many needs. We pray continuously for peace, especially in Ukraine at this time, and an end of all conflict and other troubled parts of our world. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who are finding life difficult during these days, especially economically. We pray that we in our small part may help and support those who are not so well. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in mind or body. We pray that they may find support and love that they need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur this time, the freedom of the era and the office months, the families who grieve and mourn with their loved ones. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we ask for the prayers of Mary, Mother of Christ, as we pray to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, for creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Which earth has given into human hands and made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your
hearts. Lift up your
hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Which is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created humankind, and when we were justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed us. Through Jesus, the angels praise your majesty. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we enter.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy earth and these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him live, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Love God.
You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Love God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Love God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, have your way,
that you should enter under my roof,
that only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Amen.
body of Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies anew, that what we now celebrate in signs we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord
be with you. And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you.